Here we have 11.2, graphing an exponential function and its asymptote. Again, notice that there's no vertical shift, right? It's not going to shift it up or down. This one is not going to have a vertical shift up or down. Neither is this one, neither is this one. So when I graph each of these things, they are going to have the asymptote on top of the x-axis like as before. So let's make our table. Again, I like to use these values. So if it makes you do 5 values, then just use -2, -1, 0, 1, and 2. But I think you're okay with just using the 3 values, okay? But if it does ask you for 5 values, then just use -2 and +2 as well. But I think 3 is okay. So let's go ahead and plug these in. When I plug that in, 3 over 5 raised to the power -1, I get the value 5. When I do the same expression raised to the power 0, I get 3. And when I do the same expression raised to the power 1, I get 9/5. So you could plot these two points just using the pencil and marking this point, but this one's going to be harder. So you might as well use the plot a point icon for all three, just so that you don't have to worry about trying to get in the right spot. You'll know it's in the right spot. But once you have all three of those, make sure you also plot your horizontal asymptote. So make sure you have a dotted line on top of the x-axis. And then you have -1 and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Then you have 0 and 3. And then you have 1 and 1 and 5, so probably about here. And so then it's going up and then this way. Now, it's going to the left because the base, not the coefficient, the base is a number less than 1, okay? Now let's do this one here. This base is also less than 1, so it should be going to the left side, right? But I don't think it's going to be going up on the left side. Why? Because the negative is going to reflect everything. But if you don't know your transformations that well, you can just figure the points and it will work it itself out. So let me go back to my calculator and get to the front. Let me insert a negative. I get -5. Let me change that. I get -3. And I get -9/5. So when I graph this, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, we get -1 and -5, we get 0 and -3, and then we get 1 and -1 and 4/5. So again, your horizontal asymptote is on the x-axis, and so the graph does get close to the horizontal asymptote to the right, just like it did before, but notice that instead of going up, it's going down, okay? And that's because of the negative coefficient causes it to flip over the x-axis. Now notice that this base is bigger than 1. 5/3 is 1 2/3, which is bigger than 1. So I know that it's going to go to the right, okay? It'll get close to the asymptote on the left, but it'll be going either up or down to the right. Now, because it's positive, it'll be going up. But notice that this one is negative, so most likely it's going to be going down to the right. But again, the table will tell you all of that. So if I plug these in there, let me see. 3 and then 5/3 raised to the -1. I get 9/5. When I raise it to the power 0, I get 3, and when I raise it to the power 1, I get 5. So if I plot these, again, my asymptote is on the x-axis, and I get -1, +1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So 1 and 5, 0 and 3, and then 1, -1, and 1 4/5. So it's going this direction and then this direction. I'm trying to draw it as best as I can, but you get the idea, okay? And so just like we thought, it was gonna go up towards the right because the coefficient is positive. Now over here, do the table again. So negative 1, 0, 1. And when I plug in these values into the calculator, I get negative 9 fifths, I get negative 3, and negative 5. So if I draw this on the calculator, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, or not draw it on the calculator, but draw it on my paper. I have negative 1 and negative 1 and 4 fifths, 0 and negative 3, and then 1 and negative 5. My asymptote is still on the x-axis, and then it trails off going this way and going this way. And that's pretty much how you draw these exponential functions. So you use negative 1, 0, and 1 for your x-coordinates. Tells you what's 5 points, then use these 5 points, plug them in, find the y coordinates, use your point icon, the one that looks like this, and then it opens up a box and it has this. Literally just type in the x coordinate, the y coordinate, and then you click plot at the bottom. Once you have all of your points plotted, then you just exit out of that and then put in your asymptote and then click the graph icon and it'll graph it all for you.